leftist states like our very own in California is doing something that liberal Scandinavian countries have done for years, that like you are taxed more or you are ticketed more based on your net worth or based on how fancy and new and shiny that G-Wagon you might be driving is, which is utterly outrageous. For some reason, it seems anti-socialistic, at least the socialism that Bernie claims to be selling, because it's supposed to be where everyone is treated equal, right? And in addition to that, something that you won't see in those Scandinavian countries is the majority of people do not own homes. One of the beautiful things about the American dream is people's ability to come here, better themselves, and be able to have a piece of property that they take ownership of and take care of, which in turn typically means that they are getting married, having children, and then contributing to the broader society. This is something that you don't see in these Scandinavian countries, which is why in turn they have to pay a, you know, working leave for women, et cetera, because they need their own people to populate in order to continue their growth, because it's so expensive to live there. I mean, there are so many flaws within these systems that we could spend an hour talking about them.
Right, and we should, if Bernie Sanders is going to become the front runner in any way, shape, or form, because this stuff, it's not just an argument about Scandinavian socialism. This is a man who actually praised what happened in Cuba, who actually endorsed what happened in the Soviet Union. He went on his honeymoon to the Soviet Union when it was the socialist Soviet Union. The radicalism of this man knows no bounds. That video that we showed in the monologue where Senator Sanders was questioning, interrogating Russell Vought, I can never say his name without slurring it, I don't know why, Russell Vought, about his Christian beliefs. I mean, that's really horrifying. The belief that Russell Vought had endorsed was the idea, and this is what any faithful Christian believes, that what they believe is true. That's part of what religion is. It's believing in the absolute truth of something, and by nature, believing in something as an absolute truth means that it excludes other people's religion or other people's beliefs that contradict with it. That's purely in the spiritual religious sense. That has nothing to do with the application of law. And Sanders' response to that is to say, if you don't believe as a Christian that the Muslim religion or the Jewish religion or any other religion is equally as correct as yours, then you are not really someone who this country is supposed to be about. I mean, that not only is that a horrifying idea, it's unconstitutional to try to keep someone because of their religious beliefs out of office.
Yeah, it directly flies in the face of the First Amendment. I mean, I don't understand how he could eventually, let's pray to God he doesn't, but stand there and take the oath of office to protect and defend the Constitution of the United States if he himself is not willing to apply that right of the Constitution that it grants all wonderful American citizens across the board, no matter race, gender, or ethnicity, with that First Amendment right. It's really atrocious. And as you pointed out, you know, he hasn't done the same when it comes to the radical anti-Israel, anti-Semitic freshman congresswomen that he has now publicly and privately praised.